two rounds to one. Maybe Frampton that third round.
Set up everything else. Neil has been successful in spurts with that straight.
each other so much, we realize what each other is capable of. This is one of the finest forms of athletic chess that you will find in sports. Percent of the way gone in round five. Frampton can't get in the range. He shot in a straight right and hit nothing but air. Leo is backing up nicely and comes forward with an extra right. Frampton needs to shift his feet as much as Shaper Quicken was instructing him to do so. Now Leo, he needs to keep his distance. He's expanding more.
Work out, work out, work out, work out.
In previous rounds, our friend who will counter him. Almost unloaded and blasted him with left hook.
to the rib cage of Paul Frampton.
including the hook upstairs. Look at the craftsmanship here by Leo Santacruz. Leo seeing the opening and boom! Oh, Frampton's gonna feel that tomorrow morning along the right side of his body. And Leo got a lot of torque and leverage behind those power punches. Frampton left himself open, but he was throwing his own. Very close distance, and Leo decided to go to the body and hammer him home almost just above the belt line.
All right.
Yep, bring it up.
Shoot that jab and away forward. Keep looking for that straight right hand down the pipe.
Second half of this fight has begun. Round number 7. Santacruz is looking to throw that right hand and unleash it. And if you're Leo, you should be hammering the body once again. Leo Santacruz's hands beat tonight. It's playing the factor of Frampton. Shopping right hand by the 28-year-old, now living in Los Angeles. Family men. Kids that are 4 to 2 years of age. Tonight, they realize what's at stake and they do it for the love of featherweight supremacy. The run. That's the end of the 7th. Irish fans standing, supporting their man, the Mexican Valtteri fans, or... Keep them up.
Hey, este va a ser el último que te ganan. Nomás no te descuides, que se vayan a sorprender. Que no te vayan a sorprender de un golpe, es todo. Hey, cuando el vato te vaya a ganar los golpes en la esquina, hey, gánaselos tú a él primero. Que no te ganen nunca los golpes allí.
When he's trying to push you against the ropes and he's looking to land, you have to get off first and
knock him off of you. Okay?
Yeah.
Remember, when you're bouncing forward, keep your feet underneath you, keep yourself nice and quick.
Yeah.
Faint, 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 let your hands go. That's a good round. Let's have another one of those, alright?
Approaching round number 8. Sarah Frampton was only involved in a rematch one time in his career. He defeated Kiko Martinez. And Santacruz, we saw it earlier, defeated Kiko Martinez, retaining his title after February last year before relinquishing.
Watch ahead! Watch ahead!
The man standing in front of him, Carl Frampton. Nice right hand backing up Carl Frampton. Frampton moves forward and he gets
hit
by Leo. Now Leo, using his distance, throwing those right hands, now combinations, and the speed by Santacruz.
Work out, work out, work out!
Leo going back to the body punching.
Watch ahead!
And he bounces successfully in
watch
the
ahead.
Ground.
Watch ahead,
and he bounces warning both fighters. Watch the hands. Now, Branson is almost squaring himself up as he was shifting from one chance to the other. Leo, he should be throwing right now as he turns around Frampton. Frampton trying to close the distance and the range. Leo ties up and just tries to spin him around. That's a better move for Santacruz, who's been pro for 11 years and has had 204 rounds under his belt. Fighters as well, and those both fighters' strengths. And they're looking swarm, and Santacruz tying up.
Work out, work out, stop, 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 stop.
And Leo's gonna get active here, whereas Frampton has been active in the last 10 and a half. He gets backed up. Mitchell comes through to Leo again. Looks like Frampton is the one initiating it because he's trying to close the distance. Leo has got to keep himself and use his legs to jab and fade some of the power punches from Carl Frampton. We are nearing the conclusion of round 8. Santacruz and Carl Frampton 2 here in Las Vegas. Hey!
How you feel? Yeah, feeling that, right?
Yeah.
Get some adrenaline in my eyes, David. In your flat eye.
Am I right?
Didn't win that round, all right? The only reason you didn't win it is because you're looking for too many hard shots on the inside, all right? Come on, get the little shots off on the inside,
yeah.
All right?
30 seconds.
We're round down, okay?
Yeah.
Move your head, move your head. Nice and quick on the inside, come on.
Yeah. Let's look at some of the work by Leo Santacruz, the left hook to the body. Frampton threw a left hook to answer, and Leo threw the jab, and then laying right on top of it, the right hook, or the straight right hand. We see some swelling underneath the left eye of Carl Frampton. That's largely in part to those straight right hands, which Leo has been using his reach. I gave the crowd to Santacruz. Shane McQuiggan is telling Carl Frampton, you're down by a round. Leo needs to remain on the bases, use his jab. Right hand is snuck in. Puffy takes the Frampton. Frampton looked to connect with the left hook, and Leo was out of dodge. It's a smart fight for Leo. He's not going to get involved in too much back and forth. He will engage in it, but it has to be, for the most part, on his terms. This is the pace that you want to fight at. Typically, he is all action all the time, but against a counter puncher with the precision and the ability like Carl Frampton, you have to turn things around and switch up the game plan. Jose Santacruz was adamant telling me during fight week that's what they were going to do. And using it earlier, but now he's blowing up. In order to get runs, and I'm going to go and talk about American baseball, in order to get runs, sometimes the home run isn't working for you. That big swing is not working for you, so you got to hit singles and bunts. 65 seconds left.
No, hold on.
Observing the jab fundamentals, Leo using his jab, doubling up on that jab. Frampton would throw, and he gets caught with a jab by Leo. Another one, Leo initiating it. Frampton he slipped the punch, did Santacruz, and he used his jab. And there we see the overhand right. When you use the jab and you fluster your opponents, other punches can come on top of that. And that's exactly what has been transpiring here in this fight. In the second fight, as Leo has